Hi, Michelle here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Website Content Crawler, an Apify actor designed for transforming any website into markdown files that can be fed directly into LLMs or vector databases. Whether you're building a RAG solution and turning your website into a chatbot, collecting articles from market research, or just summarizing or proofreading web pages, this actor has you covered. First, go to the link in the description, which will take you to Website Content Crawler's README. Hit try for free. You'll be prompted to create an Apify account. Don't worry, it's free and no credit card is required, ever. After logging in, you'll land on the actor's input page. While you can configure this through either the intuitive UI or JSON, we'll stick with the UI option to keep things simple. Say you want to crawl a regular website. Just enter one or more start URLs here and click start. The crawler uses reasonable defaults designed to handle most use cases effectively. Once you see the crawler in action and understand its capabilities, you can explore advanced options. For example, you can upload URLs in bulk using a .txt file or use sitemaps for broader coverage. Then choose your crawler type. The recommended choice is adaptive switching, which alternates between a raw HTTP and a dynamic browser to achieve maximum performance whenever possible. If you encounter a complex website with anti-scraping protections and JavaScript rendering, choose headless browser. For a very fast and cost-effective solution, choose raw HTTP client with Cheerio, which is an excellent choice for simpler websites that don't use JavaScript. We'll stick with adaptive switching. In crawler settings, you can choose which URL globs to include or exclude. Set up crawling depth or configure proxies. Let's keep the default configuration for now. The HTML processing step focuses on cleaning and refining the content of the crawled pages. You can remove unnecessary elements like headers, footers, and cookie warnings while preserving the main content. The actor also applies HTML transformations to simplify the page structure. We choose readable text to keep the output clean and free from navigation and other fluff. In output settings, you can change how output files look. If you're feeding output directly to an LLM or vector store, we recommend keeping the Save Markdown option turned on. Before running your actor, it's a good idea to save your configuration and create a task. This will come in handy if you want to schedule or integrate your actor with other tools in the future, or if you plan on working with multiple configurations. Now that we have the input filled out, let's run the actor using the Start button. You can watch your results appear in Overview or switch to the Log tab to see more details about the run. Now that our run is finished, we can get our data via the Export button. You can choose your desired format and which fields you want to include or exclude in your dataset. Then, just hit Download and you'll have your dataset file. For instance, here's our data in JSON open up in a new tab. If you want to automate your workflow further, you can schedule the Website Content Crawler to run at regular intervals. Choose your task and click Schedule. You can also integrate it with AI tools like LangChain, Llama Index, and Highstack, vector databases like Pinecone and Quadrant, or your custom GPTs to enhance your knowledge base. You can even connect Website Content Crawler to other cloud services such as Google Drive, Zapier, and any other Apify actor. You can also run this actor locally via API. You can find the code in Node JavaScript, Python, or Curl in the API drop-down menu in the top right corner. To learn more about retrieving data programmatically, check out our video in the card above. That's it for Website Content Crawler. Let us know what you think by leaving a comment or reporting issues in Apify Console. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell to stay notified about future content. So long, and thanks for all the likes.